I just left my doors open. I've been back here for like 3 hours or so. Not like 3 hours, like 4 hours. I'm directly under the sun, so I just want the heat to reduce fresh air to go in and push out the hot ones before I take off. So maybe I could use this opportunity just to do a slide video, just talk about one or two things. So yeah, someone called me and it was more like a complaint, but not really a complaint, you know, an observation per se. You know, he bought a Peugeot 407 V6 saloon, which is obviously automatic transmission, AMC, 6-speed automatic gearbox. So he said he was a little bit disappointed because the power he was expecting to get from the vehicle, you know, from start still acceleration, you know, wasn't getting it. Now he pressed the throttle, it doesn't move as if they possess that kind of huge power, you know, the engine, which Peugeot claim has 211 horsepower, that he wasn't getting it. You know, he presses the throttle for you to move from start. Even when he's in motion, he doesn't really respond. You have to keep pressing. It goes down a little bit before you could see the RPM of the tachometer. Yeah, the RPM climbing up before the car starts moving. So he said it was a little bit... He wasn't expecting such from such a vehicle. So I explained to him that if he was following or not following, if he was watching, if he had been watching some of my videos or my articles on Peugeot 407 V6, he would have seen that. He would have realized what he is experiencing now. He would have known this thing before making this purchase. So, yeah. But that's not the reason why I'm doing this video. I'll come to that later. The reason why I'm doing this video is, you know, it led to some other things that we discussed, which eventually made me remember that somebody has called me on this matter and complained, and I've also read it one or two places, and I've also mentioned it in some of my videos and articles, and that is, the automatic gearboxes in Peugeot car, especially the modern Peugeot vehicles, the automatic gearbox in them, they don't kick down when you want them to kick down. They only kick down when they want to. In other words, they kick down when they want to, not when you want to. Because you know what I mean by kick down, you know. You are driving, you know, just slowly or just normal speed, and there is a need for you to probably accelerate harder. Accelerate harder, so maybe you need to do some overtaking, quick overtaking and stuff like that. So you need the car to move quickly, more faster than it was going at that time. And you press the throttle further down, and sometimes it will respond. But normally it's supposed to respond, so that response is kicked down. That response means, you know, if it was on gear 6, it drops down to gear 4 or to gear 5, so that it gains more speed. So, like I said, they don't do that when you want to. They do it when they want to. So, yeah, you may start off the vehicle and take off. And yeah, you know, it will be responding. You press it, it responds. You press down, the key that comes in, until all of a sudden it will be like, no, I don't want to do it for you this time. Just because I was allowing you to enjoy it before doesn't mean I'll keep doing that. This time around, no. You try it the second time, same thing. Maybe the third time it will respond. You know. I mean, there are some cases where you just be driving of a sudden, you press it down, maybe you're on the highway and there are about 3 or 4 vehicles you know, that you need to overtake and draw, go back to this, that lane, you know, you were when you were following them from behind. You know, you put your head, press the throttle down, okay, let this car take off now. And all of a sudden, it will be like the transmission will be like, oh, let me sleep, man, why are you disturbing me? Oh, you want to overtake? Oh, let me think about it. Should I do that? Okay, maybe I should allow this kick down now. Oh, wait, are you sure you really want to kick that? You just keep delaying. It's like, honestly, I found myself in so many situations like that. It's not just like on one Peugeot vehicle, even including mine. I'm telling you, including mine with the V6 gearbox, automatic gearbox, and so many of them. I'm talking about L4. 4HP 20, HP 20, 88, 86. At least these 5 gearboxes now that I mentioned, these are the most the ones I do experience it for. I mean, if you don't know the gearbox I'm talking about, these vehicles that have them, I'm talking about Peugeot 206, Peugeot 307, Peugeot 207, Peugeot 308, Peugeot 406, Peugeot 407, Peugeot 607, Peugeot 807, and I mean, name it. There are so many, stuff maybe I don't even remember. And of course, some other vehicles with the Citroën brand. So, these 5 gearboxes, they are just the same thing in terms of that clumsy behavior sometimes. Very, very unpredictable, that's what I mean. In other words, that's just the main, more like the subject of this video. Very, very unpredictable. If you disagree with me because you claim, oh, you've been using your car for many years, you have never done that, then you have not been honest. Guys, I've driven in it. Probably you may need to. I don't allow everybody to drive my car like that unless I know you or know how good you are behind the wheel. Otherwise, even my 607, the mileage, the lowest mileage you can ever think of. Yes. So the gearbox is still like brand new. It does the same thing. And so many other ones are driven that, may not be as low as mine in terms of mileage, but very, you know, clean. And, you know, you could see that the car is barely being used that much. The gearbox, everything performed. But once you do that, it will do the same thing when you decide to do it. Very, very unpredictable. They don't just kick down anytime you want them. It can be very dangerous on highway, guys. I mean it. So it only favors those who are really not into aggressive driving. Let me put it that way. If you are not into aggressive driving, you won't really understand this. You will be on defensive or arguing that no, it doesn't happen. I'm talking about even 508. 508, yeah, okay. I didn't even mention, I even stopped at 807. Talking about 2008, 5008, RCZ, 508, what else? 408. I mean, name it. I've seen, you are looking at like 20 Peugeot cars produced from 1995 to. Yeah, almost to date. Yeah, to date, yes. Because even the new Peugeot 3008, the newest model here in Nigeria, it has the same gearbox, 86. Front of the gearboxes, 86, behave the same way. When they are cold, you know, start off, they will respond. As you leave it like 30 minutes, 40 minutes, maybe on highway, you just start doing that crap. Is it a bad thing? No, not everybody really can, you know. You may not actually experience it for doing your own ownership. It all depends on how you drive. If you're not into aggressive driving, you will really notice what I'm saying. You know, but if you are the guy that likes speed, you know, touch it, boom, immediately respond as you are pressing. If you want to understand, let me give you an example. If you want to understand gearbox, automatic gearbox that is predictable, like manual transmission, if you want to know what I'm talking about, look for any Peugeot car with ZF 4HP 22 automatic gearbox. I'll repeat it. Look for any Peugeot car with ZF 4HP 22 four-speed automatic gearbox. And how, which of the Peugeot cars that have this gearbox? Peugeot 505 V6. Mark my word. Go and look for any Peugeot 505 V6 or Peugeot 505 GTI. Peugeot 505 V6, Peugeot 505 GTI. Look for any of them. As long as they have automatic gearbox, drive them. As long as, if they are in good condition, you understand what I mean. I don't think they even have a transmission ECU. You are pressing it, vroom. You press it a little, you want to press it down immediately, it kicks down, vroom. It moves like rocket. Honestly, that's the only Peugeot car I'll be like, if I ever choose to model and say, hey, I want to own automatic transmission, Peugeot car that's very, very quick and responsive, that's one I'll probably go for. I'm not interested because I have Peugeot 505 V6, which is manual. So I don't think I'll go for the automatic just because it's very responsive. It's not like it's more responsive than manual, but it behaves close to like manual. It doesn't do that kind of I would say non kick down when you want. So it kicks down anytime you want it. It's like it knows what you want based on the your activity on the throttle pedal. As you're pressing, it's responding. So you see that it's like it's because of this modern world, they introduce ECUs, more sensors, more this thing. It starts messing up the way the transmission behaves. So that's the reason why I'm this is because people, it has come up every now and then. Why is this behaving this way? And I keep telling you, there are so many good things about automatic transmissions in Peugeot cars, but there are also the negatives. And the negative is one of the biggest things I mentioned. It's not, they don't kick down when you want to, it's when they want to. So that's the thing. My advice is, going back to the first one, first thing I said before I started this video, like the person I bought for the 407 V6 and didn't like the way the accelerator responds when it wants to move up from standstill. The mistake you made was not okay. Let me not say mistake, you already bought it. For other people who are considering buying a Peugeot 407, before you do that, the 407 V6 automatic, before you do that, look for anyone you test drive. Look for anyone you test drive. And what I mean test drive, I don't just mean drive it from here to here within a minute to drop it. No, that's not what I mean. If you can buy up to 10 liters for the owner of the car or whatever, put and then drive it as long as you know how to drive and the owner will allow you. Drive it for 20 minutes. You understand what I mean? For example, there was a guy that wanted to buy a Peugeot 407 V6 automatic. So he told me, I said, okay, maybe even though I've explained all these things to him, but you may not really understand it because you've not seen one to drive to see if you can live with those things or maybe the things I'm talking about may not even be a big deal to you because I may sound make it sound the way that or make it sound too extreme. It's okay, come. I have a Peugeot 607 V6 with the same engine and the same gearbox in 407 V6. He came. Of course, I allowed him because he paid me for the consultancy service to even help him get that one. So, yeah, it's one of the things you get to enjoy. So, don't expect because I said this thing. You just come and start expect me to give you your car, my car to drive. Not gonna happen. If you want to pay for consultancy service. So he gave him, I said, okay. Drive. took it and we went around, you know, drove it for like, was it up to 50 kilometers or thereabout. He said he was very happy. He said, no, yeah, he liked it. Yeah, you could see some of those things I've mentioned, but it's something he can live with. In fact, it wasn't even a big deal to him, even though it was to me. I was very happy. Guess what? Days or was it up to 2 weeks or thereabout, he bought a very clean one, 2009 model, that has, I forgot the mileage, as in very, very clean, almost like 4 million naira. I'm going to understand. For some V6 automatic, he bought it and he's enjoying it now. We came the other day, we changed the timing kit, you know, the timing belt, the auxiliary belt, this is service the car, this so many things, because the car is almost like brand new. He's enjoying it, you know. So go and test it, so you see all these things, you understand, okay, this is what, rather than, you know, you just take it for by what people are saying, and then you buy, only for you to not realize, or maybe you order for it, because the one you know, you prefer to order from outside Nigeria or something. By the time you get in and you go into drive, you realize, but it doesn't behave like a car that doesn't have that power, kind of power. I do praise, my point is, I do praise Peugeot 407 V6. Honestly, it's one of the best cars I've ever driven. But I'm referring to the manual, the one with the manual transmission. Because the people that experience, the person that called that is experiencing this low response on accelerator from taking off, it's because it's automatic. Go and read the manual, you will even know it's the same engine that is doing that thing in the automatic. The day I drove four, I always said that the first day I drove, in fact, that's the only time I've driven it once. 407 V6 coupe, 6-speed manual. I was like, wow, wow. Because all the other ones I've been driving were all automatic. So I was experiencing something, you know, you touch it, it won't move, and then gradually it starts moving. You know, sometimes it becomes lousy, press it down. It won't kick down immediately. Sometimes it does. It'll just be moving smoothly fast. Most times, it even behaves as if it's on sport mode all the time. Honestly, sometimes it'll just, his mind will be different. You press it a little bit, that boom, the kick down kicks in as if it's on sport mode. In fact, the RPM will even go drop until it gets to like 4,000, 5,000. As the car will just be pushing quick. One day, you just decide, come on, allow me to sleep, don't disturb me. You just start doing that nonsense. And it's not like the gearbox is faulty, that's the thing. So, but when you drive the manual, you understand it, that is, it will be a complete different animal. You know, so, that's the thing. If you want, go and test drive it. Confirm that is what you want before you buy. That's my point. If you drive it and like it, buy it. No point, then follow the maintenance schedule. Change the ATF when it's due. Don't let it go beyond 30,000 kilometers. Change the ATF with the recommended one, no matter how expensive it is. I mentioned so many ways to use it. If you want to use it on sport mode, use it. Don't use it for a very long time, like use it for up to 3 hours. No, don't. Use it when you want to do some quick acceleration, then put it back to normal distance. Don't let it stay there on automatic mode for a long time. You know, that's the thing. So I hope this video explains a lot. So I think that's all for now. If you have any more questions, you can add. This is not to bash automatic gearbox. It's just to tell you some of the annoyances that are there. Most people don't talk about. They only tell you how good it is. But when you now buy, after a while, you start experiencing them. But those who are into automatic will not see all this. If you love automatic transmission, trust me, you won't find all this fault I'm talking about. Or if you are into quick accelerating vehicles, that's when you may find it. But if you are just into maybe just a normal drive, you will find it. You will be like, guy, I'm talking off point. I'm talking about different transmission, not the ones in your vehicle. So that's the thing. So that's all for now.